quite a lot. Konrad Bussen of DWTV for Channels Television at the Frankfurt Stock Exchange. Let's return to the marketplace, of course, particularly the Wall Street, where the stocks and the futures were looking red on Tuesday ahead of the open on Wall Street as concerns over rising interest rates dampen investor sentiments once again. So look at the Dow Jones Industrial Average futures down 0.37%. The S&P 500 also down 0.38%, just as shy of the Dow, and the Nasdaq in the same negative territory. Okay, let's move on to the Chinese markets, where a partial recovery was made today after yesterday declines following the country's central bank cutting the reserve ratio for banks over the weekend. The Shanghai Composite Index rose 0.17%, while the Shenzhen Composite lost its earlier gains to end largely flat at about 1,385. Australia's ASX 200 was down almost 1%. The Japanese Nikkei 225 closed lower this Tuesday by 1.32%, and the TOPIX Index fell 1.76%. Hong Kong's Hang Seng continued to beat the region's downward trend to trace slightly higher, despite losing its earlier gains. So let's check in with the world of commodities, with a focus on the global energy markets, where the price of liquefied natural gas, or LNG, has increased sharply over 15% in the last 4 weeks. Now, let's have a research analyst at Financial Derivatives Company, Adedayo Ogunniran, here in Lagos, join us from our downtown studio. Coming back home to all of us in terms of liquefied natural gas. Adedayo, thank you. It's good to see you. So we're having this spike in liquefied natural gas. Where is this coming from? Is there a shortage of production or supply? Is it about the freight? What is it?
Okay, so in any market where there is no price control, price would change. Price would increase because of two reasons. One, when there is an increase in demand, and two, when there is a contraction in supply. So the factors that drove up the global price of energy were mainly demand factors. Winter is approaching. So we've seen, and because LNG is used for heating, we've seen an increase in demand for LNG in the US and Europe. And in the US as well, we've gotten reports that inventories in the country are very low. In fact, right now they are at their lowest point in over 10 years. So these factors together have mainly explained why the price has increased.
Adedayo, LNG, liquefied natural gas, accounts for about 12.6% of Nigerian exports. So what are the implications of this price increase on the global space for Nigeria's balance of trade and the value of the Naira and all that?
Thank you. So LNG accounts for 12.6% of Nigeria's total exports, and it's Nigeria's second largest exports after oil. So it's a good news for all of these variables you just mentioned. It's good for the trade balance. It's good for the external reserves. It's also good for the balance of payments and the capital accounts. So Nigeria's Nigeria recorded a trade balance of $6.5 billion in the second quarter of 2018. That trade balance means the difference between the exports and the imports. So if there's an increase in price of LNG, it means that the export is likely going to increase further, and that would widen the trade surplus. Where do these surpluses go? They go into the capital accounts. And if the outflows and payments from the capital accounts are less than the inflows, then we are likely going to see more surpluses from that end, which is now going to filter into the external reserves. And an increase in external reserves would mean a stronger Naira. It's in fact a very good news right now, because reserves have been depleting. So while we are likely still going to see some outflows from the capital accounts, more inflow from the LNG, earnings, means the level of depletion in the external reserves will likely be contained.
Yes, so that's good news, because that's the dollar. Exactly. We're talking about dollars here, Adedayo. So that's sweet music to my ears. But for millions of Nigerians who use the liquefied petrol gas, which is the LPG, or what you call the cooking gas in local currency, and that's currently between 4,200 Naira and 4,500 for a 12.5 kg cylinder. Would they be knocked by this LNG price increase in the near term?
Thank you, Bozin. That's another very intelligent question. So LPG, the cooking gas, as one of the major inputs of this LPG is LNG. All right, and the demand for LPG in Nigeria, the demand for this cooking gas has actually increased rapidly in recent years. It has increased because it is cleaner, it is more environment friendly, and it is more convenient to use compared to other alternatives like kerosene, fuel, kerosene, wood, and coal. So, but the demand is usually met through imports, and that has made Nigeria's the price of domestic LPG highly vulnerable to volatilities in global LNG prices. So, like, it's something to be worried about. Every flower has its thorn, that's how it is said. So for every good news, before I said it's a good news for the Nigeria, for Nigeria's macroeconomy, but consumers would be now be worried about the possibility of an increase in domestic LPG prices. But it's not going to be immediate. It's going to be for some time, because it's the price we are talking about is actually in the futures market. So maybe subsequently, in subsequent months, if the price increase is sustained, we are likely going to see that increase the landing cost of LPG in Nigeria.
What a very nice way to put it for us this afternoon. Thank you very much, Adida Yogunira, one of the research analysts at Financial Derivatives on Skype from their office in downtown Lagos. Let's come back to you after the break for the balance of the show, Your Business Incorporated.